justice of all.
Johnson, can I speak with you?
I'll be back in a moment. When I get back, someone will be helping me at the board.
Hey, Mo, who coming this weekend?
Me!
Well,
no, her ass ain't coming, but I'ma be there.
She's coming. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a difficult moment for America. Today, we've had a national tragedy. Two airplanes have crashed into the World Trade Center in an apparent terrorist attack on our country and have ordered that the full resources of the federal government go to help the victims and their families and to conduct a full-scale investigation to hunt down who committed this act. Terrorism against our nation will not stand. May God bless the victims, their families, and America. Thank you very much.
That's Air Force One you see in Florida, the president on board.
Don't worry, students. Whatever it is, we're going to be okay.
But Miss J, this is crazy.
For now, we're going to go back to our lesson. So, who's ready to solve number 10? Anyone? That's what I thought. I'm giving you 3 minutes to figure it out. Go.
Also have a report now that it was a plane that crashed into the Pentagon, and we have a large fire at the Pentagon. The Pentagon is being evacuated as we speak now. The White House has been evacuated as well.
Oh my gosh, Deanna. Quiet,
all of you, quiet now.
All classes prepare for early dismissal. If you need to make a phone call, tell your teacher. Patrols report to the office.
Okay, grab your stuff and head down. Everyone else, start packing up. Quietly. Anyone who makes a sound will be written up.
In the last 5 minutes, people have come running out of the White House and the old executive office building. So this is the office building right directly across from the White House. About 10 minutes ago, there was a white jet circling overhead. Now, you generally don't see planes in the area over the White House. That is restricted airspace. No reason to believe the jet was there for any nefarious purposes, but the Secret Service was very concerned, pointing up at the jet in the sky. It is out of sight now, best we can tell. They've evacuated the entire White House staff and the old executive office, as well as some townhouses that are government offices. Many of our viewers might know Blair House or another.
What up, Mila?
Hey, Drew.
So, you coming this weekend or not?
Is that really all you can think about?
You mean about TV? Then I come in here.
Whatever. Bye, Drew.
Tell your mom asked her happy birthday.
The full resources of the federal government are working to assist local authorities to save lives and to help the victims of these attacks. Make no mistake, the United States will hunt down and punish those responsible for these cowardly acts.
Assalamu alaikum, little Nailah.
Walaikum assalam, Mr. Ibrahim.
So, what you whipping up today?
Well, I'm making a cake for my mama's birthday.
Ah, mashallah. Tell Miriam I said happy birthday. And to call me, so that her brother can take her out. So tell me, Mila, have you spoken to your mom since all of this started? The news said the phone towers are down in D.C.
Well, we couldn't use the phones in school. Plus, it's her late day.
join me in saying a prayer for the victims and their families.
I know she likes this.
I'll tell her they're from you.
The resolve of our great nation is being tested. Make no mistake. We will show the world that we will pass this test. God bless you.
All routes running into D.C. are experiencing severe delays. The Pentagon stop is closed. I repeat, due to this morning's events, all routes running into D.C. are experiencing severe delays. The Pentagon stop is closed.
Past 10 o'clock Eastern Daylight Time. Let me just briefly recap.
Hi, Jamila.
Hey.
American cities, New York.
Hey, Auntie.
Hey, you're home early.
Yeah, they let us out because of this.
This is crazy.
Have you talked to Mom lately?
I'm sure she's fine. Inshallah. Plus, it's her late day, remember?
Well, I have some cake mixed for Mom's birthday.
Oh, okay. How about this? I'll stay till she gets back.
Okay.
Alrighty. Plus, I get to have some cake too. And I get to wish your mama a happy birthday myself. Yeah. Okay?
Yeah, I'm sure she'll like that.
Good, good, good.
About half an hour or so after the first one, we have a report. CNN has been told that an American Airlines 767 jet was hijacked out of Boston today. We don't know which of those two.
David Ensor joins us from Washington. David, where in the Capitol are you now?
Well, Aaron, I'm in our bureau, but I have on the telephone with me Barbara, who is the wife of a friend of mine and who is an eyewitness to exactly what happened at the Pentagon. Barbara, can you hear me all right?
Can you? Yes, I can hear you.
Well, what exactly did you see? Let's look at the Pentagon now as you describe what exactly happened at the Pentagon this morning.
As we were driving into town on 395, there was an exit. We were trying to get off the exit for the Memorial Bridge. Off to the left-hand side was a commercial plane that came in and was coming too fast and too low. And the next thing we saw was it go down below the side of the road, and we just saw the fire.
Allahu Akbar.
Allahu Akbar.
Allahu Akbar.
Allahu Akbar.
Assalamu alaikum rahmatullah.
Assalamu alaikum rahmatullah.
Assalamu alaikum rahmatullah.
Assalamu alaikum rahmatullah.
Attack on America, a special edition of NBC Nightly News. Terrorists declare war on the United States, hijacking jetliners, crashing them into New York's World Trade Towers. Another airliner...
Nailah, Uncle Musa called and David is sick. I've got to go. Do you want me to give the peeler a bath?
No, it's okay. I got it.
America wondering, what next?
If you need anything, and I mean anything, you call me.
Yes, I know. We'll be fine.
Stunning series of attacks today against targets in New York and in Washington, D.C., the World Trade Center and...
Tell Miriam I said happy birthday.
Terrorists used hijacked civilian airliners and their passengers...
Auntie?
Yes?
...in their attack.
Never mind. It isn't important.
Okay.
The dead still are being counted. An unknown number still are missing. At this hour, in this war, another development. There are reports out of Kabul tonight, the capital of Afghanistan, of explosions. The Pentagon and the sea...
Come on, Troy. I'm done. Trump.
soon as Mama gets here, I'll wake you up so I can cut you a piece.
A cake?
Okay, yeah, a cake.
Okay. The turtle.
You want the turtle?
Yeah.
Okay, come on. Gotta lay down first.
No, this one is.
This is music? Okay, here you go.
Directed the full resources of our intelligence and law enforcement communities to find those responsible and to bring them to justice. We will make no distinction between the terrorists who committed these acts and those who harbor them. And we stand together to win the war against terrorism. Tonight I ask for your prayers for all those who grieve. For the children whose worlds have been shattered. For all whose sense of safety and security has been threatened. And I pray they will be comforted by a power greater than any of us, spoken through the ages in Psalm 23. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil, for you are with me.
Heaven's prison. Come see me.
Shit, sorry!
No, my fault.
David?
Yes. Hi, Martha.
Oh, sorry I'm late.
You look very nice.
Oh, thanks.
Would you like a drink? Cheers.
Cheers.
Martini. Oh. Here's one for you. Mm. I have had time to plan this one. Shag, marry, and avoid. Mm-hmm. Zippy, George, and Bungle.
David, have you seen my lipstick? David!
Thank you.
Stop.
Thank you, dick.
I'm shitting myself.
Why?
Your parents are from Tunbridge Wells.
Royal Tunbridge Wells.
Mm-hmm. Is now the time to tell them we're cohabiting?
I told them already.
And about how we met?
No, no, maybe don't mention that bit.
Too slutty?
Always.
Not for you, for your mother.
You didn't need to take the whole day off.
I didn't.
It's a job interview for an estate agent. You don't need to make it more awful than it actually is. Tea?
I'm going in at 10:30.
Tea?
Yeah, go on then. Thanks, waiter.
Fuck off.
I hope you're gonna get a new suit for the wedding.
Here we go.
No, I'm not starting, David, I was joking. We talked about this. David!
David!
For God's sake, David, slow down!
Gone. It's gone. Fucking stupid idea.
What is?
Martha, I bought you an engagement ring. That's the reason why we're here. And you were meant to find it. And it was meant to be romantic.
Oh.
I'm sweating my tits off and I'm 1,300 quid worse off.
Okay.
Why are you laughing?
Sorry, I'm not.
I don't know why I bother.
Because you love me?
Not anymore, I think.
Well, I love you!
Right. It's in a small box with a red bow on it. And I remember there being... Fuck off.
David.
No.
David.
No, Martha, this is completely wrong.
David. It's up there. That'd be a big fuck off diamond. Not forever.
Don't.
You're sounding like a child.
Whose fault's that?
Don't make me say it.
My mother's. Do you ever wish I was a millionaire?
Always. Do you ever wish I was?
I'm hoping.
Me too. Millionaire with a house husband. Mm. Seriously, though, if I was, we'd have a wedding planner and a vegan option for my sister. Shit, who I haven't texted.
I'm not gonna let your old man pay for it all.
I know. I got you a present for your interview.
Fuck's sake. I can afford to dress myself.
David, it's a pair of... David! Not for you, for your mother. Talk to her, Jimmy.
Bin bag.
Oh, damn it.
Do we got time?
No. Get him. Mother ask when you're gonna propose yet?
Bet she did.
What'd you tell her?
One day. Just wait until she's a grandmother.
Definitely have sex with Zippy.
Good call.
You?
George.
George is a boy.
George is a girl.
No, George is a boy. Google it. You'll see I'm right.
George is an effeminate anthropomorphic pink hippo.
Anthro what?
Wikipedia. I believe on a first date you should leave an unforgettable impression.
Ah. Hippo fucker.
Camping's great if you like camping.
Shut up.
We could go camping.
Or you could just kiss me.
No, I like camping.
I think you should.
Kiss you now. Yeah.
It's not promising.
More drink.
Yeah, go on. David?
That everything?
The box is at the bottom of the wardrobe for my dad to collect on Saturday.
Cool.
Bye, Both sets need to be with the estate agent when the tenancy runs out.
And you're okay if I just stay on?
Well, whenever the tenancy ends, the inventory's in the drawer, so... If you pick up the Hoover, I'll let you keep the deposit.
Thanks.
It's always a first time.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
Perhaps it was for the best.
Really?
I just need to not have you in my life. Take this, sell it, use the money.
Nah, you keep it.
My fault.
Here we go again. Trying hard, but you wanna be my friend. Ain't no place to hide, ain't no one to run to. Here we go again. Call my bluff, I'ma be here till the end. I'm the one you ride, I'm the one you ride to. If you don't wanna change, ain't no place to hide, ain't no one to run to. If you don't wanna change.
These days I always have the same thoughts, turning around and around, and I wanna know if I could be anything that would help you stand taller, and I wanna know if this could be.
I didn't know I needed to. Come on, get up. You can't be late for work today. You've got like 15 minutes.
Right. Well, maybe if you didn't treat me like a hopeless mental case, I could drive myself to
school.
We're
not getting into this right now.
Problem resolved, right?
And it's your dad's weekend, so he's picking you up from school, okay?
Okay. Well, you can just tell him I'm not going to be there, so.
Look, Maddy, I'm not a fan of your dad's either, but I think he's trying. Just give him a chance, okay? Get up. Now.
Remember me.
Hey, Maddy. Hey.
Go screw yourself, okay?
Hey, come on.
Hey, why do you keep shutting me out? Huh? No matter what I do, you just won't let me in.
You're the one that left. Okay, so don't you dare put this on me.
Yeah, you're right. I screwed up.
Yeah, you did.
Yes, but it doesn't take away from the fact that I love you, Maddy.
You love me? Just like you love Mom?
She won't be home for hours, I swear.
Come on, Mick. No, stop.
Don't be a tease.
Stop! Mick, stop! Get off of me! Let go!
No matter what I do, you just won't let me. Just
I love you.
Don't overreact. You're right. You screwed up.
Maddy.
What?
Oh my God. Maddy? Michael! Michael, hurry, it's Maddy! Oh my God.
Why are you doing this?
I was just bringing you to all your favorite memories.
What would ever make you think that these are my favorite memories?
They're the ones you think about all the time.
Maddy? Hey, come on, baby, wake up. Maddy, wake up.
Daddy?
I'm so sorry, sweetie. I'm so sorry.
He can't hear you.
Honey?
Does she have a pulse?
Just barely, but yeah.
Just barely. Please hurry.
Hey, hey.
Oh my God. It's okay, sweetie. It's okay. Come here, babe. Come here. It's okay.
This is my fault.
What'd you do with Maddy?
I was sad.
Why? Mommy and Daddy love you so much. You're a princess.
What?
Come on. I'll show you my favorite memory. Come on.
Maddy, happy birthday.
Oh, Mom, it's beautiful.
Oh, it's a beautiful cake for a beautiful princess. I love you.
Love you too.
And I have a big surprise for you.
Oh, this is the best part. Oh, Daddy, love it.
Oh.
Oh, thank you. Oh.
Princess Madeline.
I love you. They're here.
Okay, let's go. Come on.
Are you ready to get this party started?
All right.
Oh, I gotta go. The party's starting. Wait. You are home.
What's that?
Your alarm clock, silly.
Maddy, turn your alarm off. I'm trying to sleep in.
This?
What are you talking about, huh?
Never mind.
Thank you. What was that for?
Nothing.
I gotta go.
Where are you going?
Pass. Come in.
Of course.
Remember me.
He will turn the hearts of the parents to their children, and the hearts of the children to their parents.
Someone told me that courage is a choice. You gotta act even when you're scared. But I've never been good at choosing. I don't know what made me get in the truck that night. I hate Tom. I guess I was just tired of being scared.
Come
The Carpenters are having people over tonight after the game. I promised Deanne that we would go.
You're the only one who wants to go to this party.
I promised her we would go.
Hey, Maggie. Do you want to go to some lousy, stuffy party tonight? Or do you want to go get ice cream?
Yeah.
Extra fudge! That's what I'm talking about.
You would bring her into this. Do I embarrass you?
Just stop.
I just want you to start something, anything.
Articulate. What, Brenda?
I've been associated with wrong my whole life. Wrong house, wrong family, wrong name. But the thing you would never guess,
try this one up here.
I never wanted to do anyone wrong.
Freeman, go ahead. You serious, Freeman?
Damn it all.
Being alone isn't bad, but it's nice to be a part of something.
It's okay to be scared, Freeman.
Pull over here, I gotta take a piss.
It's in the can.
I'm pissed the man with your driving, bro. Come on.
You ever seen a fly just going about their day, no one paying attention to it, and then...
You got a problem?
Slap. Someone finally does.
You think you're the only cowboy out here?
About this thing, so we had Maggie, that everybody makes a tiny cake and then they have the baby smash it.
It's like a rite of passage for babies now. This isn't that good of a story. I don't know why you brought this story.
I asked him to pick up a cake mix on the way home just so we could make it for the party, and I said vanilla, but I guess I should have been more specific because he came home with banana bread mix.
Yes. It's pretty easy to confuse those things. Yeah. It looks just like vanilla. I mean,
right.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. It's easy to, like, it's not like I got, you know, dark chocolate or something.
Right.
Right. Let's hope so.
Was that a 357?
It's a 44.
My dad used to keep a Desert Eagle under his pillow.
You ever get to use it?
Once. When I was 6 or 7, my dad came home late one night, drunk. And the next thing I heard was my mom screaming. So I ran into the room, and my dad was choking my mom over the bed. So I grabbed the gun and I shot it into the air.
Why didn't you shoot him?
What the hell did you get a turkey for?
Whoa, whoa.
Come on.
We're doing it. We're doing it.
I'm tired of throwing cans. I want to throw some punches. Woo! What about you, Freeman? You want to beat some ass?
Who are we gonna fight?
We? How about you and me? I'll even let you have the first swing.
I'm not trying to fight you, man.
I've been feeling cornered my whole life. That night was no different.
See, that's your problem, Freeman. You're just scared. It's okay to be scared, Freeman.
When I was little, my mom used to sing me a song that said, "Farther along, we'll know all about it. Cheer up, my brother, live in the sunshine. We'll understand it all by and by." I'm not very good at choosing, but running's never been much of a choice.
Tempted and tried, we're oft made to wonder why it should be thus all the day long, while there are others living about us, never molested, though in the wrong. Father, along we'll know all about it. Father, along we'll understand why. Cheer up, my brother, live in the sunshine. We'll understand it all by and by. Father, along we'll know all about it. Father, along we'll understand why. Cheer up, my brother, live in the sunshine. We'll understand it all by and by.
I know that some things are done on purpose, and some things are done on accident.
You really think people change? Change is impossible. It stays in the blood.
It's like everyone knows the worst thing about you before you even open your mouth.
Come on, man, I'm just trying to help you. Why are you running?
You're gonna tell me the truth, or you'll be on your way.
Everyone in this town talks.
The nice thing about living in a small town is that everyone has secrets. Everyone is hiding some things.
Yeah, and what are you hiding?
From you? Nothing.
It's quiet, and then some nights it's too quiet.
Don't you ask me how I'm doing! You don't get to ask me how I'm doing!
Let me tell you something, you're a Freeman. And you should be proud of that name.
Chris, is that you? Do you know what you are putting me through? The cops are showing up.
Amy, I gotta tell you something.
I heard what you did, Chris. Just please tell me it's not true. You wouldn't hurt anyone.
bouche, c'était ses frêles épaules, structure organique, des formes accrochées, des étoffes moirées, des plumes, des galons, des perles féritiques.
Thank you. Maybe I should chop off my hair real quick. Two extra pounds on me. I'm like, fuck. I need to be at 136.6. But I think I can sweat it off.
Country knows that you're one of the top contenders.
This is probably the toughest tournament in the nation.
So a lot of times they're like, oh wow, they let women wrestle.
In my area, I was the only girl on my team. So I had to learn how to assert my dominance around the guys.
My first match, it was just like getting hit by a truck. I was like, oh my god, I felt a bit violated when I got off the mat, you know.
You'll see people that don't have as much talent go out there and beat top-tier athletes just because they're tougher and they have more heart.
I make sure that I'm hurt.
You know, Eva's gonna be wrestling some of the best that are around. It's a scary thing, like, most people don't have the courage to do this. It's not easy.
Sometimes I have these urges to call random people I haven't talked to for a long time. And I picked up the phone, I called my friend who's a wrestling coach, I asked him if he knew any submission type fights. He said, well, I don't know about that, but there's the wrestling tournament at the US Open.
She was going to the gym and working out a lot. And then one day she comes home and says, I'm gonna go to take karate at this class. And the next thing we knew, she was a white belt or brown belt or something belt. And she got better at it, better at it, better at it. Now, how that led to wrestling, I don't know. And I'm not real crazy about that.
Suplex City on three! One, two, three!
Suplex City!
Excellent.
I just got introduced to the wrestling community and I just fell in love with it. That's as simple as it is. Because everyone's got different backgrounds, but we're all coming together to just wrestle. Yeah, it's hard. Yeah, it's gonna be embarrassing. You know, it's a whole journey of like getting ready for it. I'm vastly underprepared no matter what I do. But at the same time, the best time to start anything is right when you feel you need to do it. I was a tomboy. I was playing outside all day. My mom was always telling me, don't wear the basketball shorts and the big t-shirt. I wanted to wrestle, but that was not something that girls do. I think it's all about, I needed it, an outlet. When I started training, it was January of last year, and I just started working my butt off. I didn't tell anybody what was happening. I didn't tell anybody when I booked my first fight on Craigslist. I didn't say anything. I just like started really building this fire. Now, having the chance to wrestle, I'm gonna take it.
Nice.
I manifested at least 4-5 people into my life, experts at various types of martial arts, open to me picking their brain about it. When I was looking desperately for something that would help me win these fights that I found on the internet.
advertisement for female fighters, Fight Club. I decided I'm gonna try it out. We fought for an hour. She was smaller than I am, but much more experienced fighting. She got, I think, two or three submissions in a row, and I fought hard, and I lost. She definitely kicked my butt. I don't know, I was still into it for some reason. Every time I go, I get better. After my first match, I realized it's something that I can do. Because in the beginning, I didn't even know if I could do it. This is 14 days old.
Still.
Yeah. And then this one is like, it's not that bad.
Still.
Yeah.
She had emailed some pictures of her injuries. Oh my God, she's fractured that knee. And then her knuckles, she had scraped those, and she had some other bruises. But, you know, like she got right back on the horse and made herself better, and now she's gonna go to this tournament. She assures me that, you know, she's can do it, she won't get hurt. I'm hoping.
I don't mind having an adverse experience. I've had since the beginning. I mean, I was 11 months old as a little girl, 11 months old, and my mom was shot and killed in front of me.
People talk about adopted kids being lucky. It's really the parents, you know, that are fortunate and have the luck and the love.
Eve's biological mother had been killed in a murder-suicide. And Eve had been left alone for almost 4 days without any food, water being changed.
She is very independent. She can go off and do her own thing, and I can sit here and worry, you know, about it. But yeah, she has no fear. She has no fear of doing those things.
The thing is, my spirit needs to do this. Winning my first match, my heart just swelled up with, like, oh my God, I can't believe it, I just won. Like, I was crying. And I just didn't give up, I didn't tap out, I didn't give her the submission. So I was swollen up with pride and happiness, and it gave me confidence more than anything.
didn't throw punches. She wasn't throwing punches. She's got a small body. She's got real strong shoulders, so she would just grab onto my neck and crank it. And I can take it for so long, but after an hour of fighting, you don't want to take any chances. And I see her little body, I'm like, in my head, I'm like, come on, Eve, like, be big, stand strong, like, use your muscles, be strong. And then a voice in my head telling me, you're weak, like, you're so weak, you know.
Am I really about to enter the world of wrestling? Showing up to all the practices and just getting completely destroyed and getting my ass kicked every time.
I feel so inhibited. I just hear all the reasons I shouldn't be doing this. Like, a real negative thing inside creeps up little by little.
She has approached this as she does anything. Failure's not an option, and she's very committed to get where she wants to go.
Oh, Evie. Somehow, this girl has to make it.
She was speed walking earlier, like that.
Oh, I just drank a cup of coffee. That's what happened, and I haven't eaten all day.
Remember, bring it in the morning.
I'm gonna have four pieces of spinach, one little chunk of avocado with pepper on it, and like a hot sauce plot.
If you keep this tight, the rest of your body will do the right thing. Go ahead, go. Twist. There you go. You ready? Good. Switch your feet. There, you got me. You have to think of yourself as the matador. Yeah. And I'm being the bull.
Yeah.
And you're going, ole!
Yeah, I don't know why it's so awkward.
Nice. Good. Ooh, good job. Turn away. And then, perfect. You see how you got tight at the end?
Yeah.
That was it.
Yeah.
She surprises me. She's surprising me a lot right now.
Good. Barely made it. 61.5 kilograms. I'm competing in 62 kilograms. So,
we're safe.
Let's go.
I felt the first like head touch and that felt good, but then I think my adrenaline kicked in and I got scared like I was gonna get punched. That sucks that it was so fast, but it was awesome to wrestle her.
The expression of fight or flight. It's really a magical thing. When you're in a survival situation, something comes out of the blue, it's a passion, it's love, it's spirit, whatever it is, and it comes through at the very last minute and it saves you. But I don't want to rely on that. I've relied on that most of my life. That's my biggest wrestling match, I think. Positive. I am growing. And nothing can go wrong. Even if I get 11th place, I still have the most badass style. And it's strong. And even though maybe I wasn't quick enough, I wasn't reactive enough to my opponent, and maybe they have 20 more years of experience than I do, I still know that in expressing myself, I'm gonna get exactly what I want out of this tournament. Which is just to make a splash, to represent my friend Isaac Well, Team Puma, and do my thing, and not let anything else get in the way of that.
all the hardships I've gone through. All the pain I've endured. All the shame I have felt for years. All of it's going to end. I'm going to take back what's mine. I'm finally gonna get back at the monster that ruined my life. It's time to make him suffer like he's made me suffer. All the preparation. All the training. All the blood, the sweat, the tears. It's all led to this.
What's going on? Where am I?
Yeah, you must be pretty confused right now. Scared even.
Who are you? Why are you doing this?
Bet you're wondering to yourself why all this is happening to you.
Tell me, please. You have the wrong guy. I've never done anything to anybody. Please, you have the wrong guy.
Oh, no. You're the right guy. You're gonna pay for what you did.
Bill. Bill, is that you?
It's been a long time, Uncle Cameron.
Billy, why are you doing this?
I'm doing what I should have done a long time ago. I'm taking back what's mine.
I never took anything from you. I didn't take anything from you.
You don't fucking pretend like you don't know what I'm talking about. You took the most important thing in the world to me and ruined my whole goddamn life. Every day, I wake up with emptiness inside because of you and what you did to me. And that's why you're here. You're gonna give me back what is rightfully mine.
This has to be some kind of mistake. This is a mistake!
You want to play it that way, huh? You want to play stupid? Fine. Then I'll just tear it out of you. Last chance, you bastard. Give me back my goddamn nose!
Hey, Billy.
I got your nose.
Come and get it.